Welcome back. I'm joined now by local author Joseph Caldwell, and we're going to discuss his new book release. As you can see, we have a couple books on the table. How are you doing today?
I'm doing fine.
Good. Thank you so much for coming in. We really appreciate it. And this is obviously exciting. You have a book signing coming up. So
yes.
First of all, let's talk a little bit about your background. How did you get into this?
My career was with Forest Service.
Okay.
And I retired quite a few years ago. But one of my assignments was in southern Utah. In the canyon country, and I fell in love with the geology of the Colorado Plateau. But I've been writing all my life, and I finally decided to start doing something with it, and so that's why I started doing the books.
Okay, and then what are your books primarily about? It looks like they are about the outdoors.
They're nature-related.
Okay.
I have three books that are basically short essays, nature-related essays, and that's what the Echoes of Time is.
Okay.
I have one novel and a book of short stories, but they all are about the environment and, like I say, nature-related.
Awesome. Okay, and then the newest book is Echoes of Time, so we'll show you guys what that looks like. It's this book right over here, and this says it's reflections on the mesas and canyons of the Dominguez Escalante National Conservation Area. So what made you want to write this? What inspired you?
It's too long a story to get into, but I just fell in love with the country. It kind of reminded me a little bit of Utah, but actually Utah looks like western Colorado, so you could look at that either way.
Mm-hmm.
Sort of the underlying theme of the whole thing is the geologic time involved. And from the bedrock that's in Escalante Canyon and the same as in the Black Canyon of the Gunnison, it's 1 billion years old.
Yeah.
And on top of that are all kinds of thousands of feet of layers of rock that are only a few hundred million years old.
Mm-hmm.
But the whole history of the Uncompahgre Plateau, the thing was part of the ancestral Rocky Mountains millions of years ago. It rose up to who knows how high.
Yeah.
And then it all eroded back down, was covered with a lot of the sandstones and shales that make up the Colorado Plateau, and then it rose again.
Mm-hmm.
So the fact this thing has been up and down and just the millions of years of history I find fascinating.
No, absolutely it is. And it's definitely, they are formations that you don't typically see in other parts of the U.S., so it's very interesting.
Yeah, for example, the Colorado National Monument outside of Grand Junction, that's Wingate Sandstone. That's only 200 million years old.
Well, only. That's nothing.
Right.
Awesome.
And
okay.
A lot of the, the floor of the valleys around here is Manco Shale, which was deposited at the bottom of what they call the Cretaceous Seaway, which was something like 80 million years ago. But right, if we went back 80 million years, right now we'd be sitting underwater.
Yeah.
Because of this fantastic ocean, and all this was deposited, and again, the ground and the seas went up and down over time. And but what I get into in the book is not only the geologic time, but as well the wildlife, the human history, the natives that went back over 10,000 years, and then the recent settlers. And so it's just a wide diversity. It goes all the way from Delta to Whitewater,
wow.
And then from Highway 50 in the Gunnison River all the way up to where it meets the National Forest.
Okay.
And right in your backyard, right in our backyard here, besides all the other things like Grand Mesa, we have just an immense diversity of wildlife, of geology, of rocks, human history, and it's just fascinating. It's available to all of us.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much for coming in once again. It is Echoes of Time, and he will be at Barnes & Noble this Saturday for a book signing from 2 to 4, so definitely stop by. Thank you again for coming in, and
thank
we
you.
Will be right back after a quick break.